Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome to Repair and Replace. If your refrigerator is warm, but the freezer is still cold, then it's most likely an issue with the airflow. The evaporator fan pushes cold air from the freezer to the fridge compartment. If the fan stops working, or if there's a blockage, air will not circulate and the fridge will not cool properly. As well, a faulty sensor or control board can also create temperature issues. In this episode, first, we'll learn how it all works. Then we'll access and test each component with a multimeter. This applies to most top freezer, bottom freezer, and side-by-side refrigerators. All refrigerators work in the same basic way. When cooling is needed, the cold control sends power to the cooling circuit. The compressor pushes the refrigerant through the system. In the freezer, heat is extracted by the evaporator coils and is released through the condenser coils behind the refrigerator. This process continues until the set temperature is reached. Cold air from the freezer is circulated into the fridge through a small vent. The damper controls the amount of air that is circulated into the fridge. This is often controlled by adjusting a slider in the freezer. In some cases, ice can block this vent. Models with a control board will have a damper motor. If the motor fails and the damper is stuck closed, then cold air will not circulate into the fridge. Alternatively, a faulty evaporator fan will not circulate enough air between both compartments. Some models have a temperature sensor in the fridge and another in the freezer. If one of the sensors is faulty, then it can prevent that compartment from cooling properly. Using a multimeter, components can be tested for continuity. A continuity test will determine if there's a continuous path for electricity to flow through. Without continuity, the component will not work and will need to be replaced. First, make sure that nothing is blocking the air vents. Next, check for a buildup of ice in the freezer. If the evaporator coils are covered in heavy ice, it'll reduce the heat transfer and the refrigerator will not cool properly. Throughout the day, the defrost cycle runs to melt the ice on the coils. If the defrost controller, the heating element, or the defrost thermostat is faulty, then the cycle won't run and ice will build up. You can see how to troubleshoot the defrost system in the video linked below. Excessive frost can be a sign that the door seal is compromised. If the door gasket is not sealing properly, it will let humid air into the freezer and fridge. This will also prevent the refrigerator from cooling properly. You can see how to do this in the video linked below. To begin, you might need a screwdriver or nut driver and a multimeter. Keep in mind there is some variation between models, and not all refrigerators will have the same parts. You can enter your model number on the AMRE Supply website to see a parts breakdown. This can be helpful to show you which parts are in your refrigerator and where they are located. First, slide the refrigerator out from the wall. When there is enough room, unplug the cord to disconnect the power. In this case, you can work on the refrigerator in place with it still against the wall. Since the evaporator fins are sharp, it's best to wear cut-resistant gloves. To access the evaporator coils, you'll have to remove the screws to the freezer cover panel. Lift up the mounting tabs and remove the panel. If the fan is mounted to the panel, you might need to disconnect the wire harness. In a side-by-side fridge, the fan will likely be mounted above the evaporator coils. To isolate the fan, disconnect the wires and remove it. If your model has a bottom freezer, then you'll have to remove the door to access the freezer components. You can see how to do this in the video linked below. If the evaporator fan is not running, then it won't circulate air over the coils. First, check if the fan blades spin freely. If it feels restricted or if there's any visible damage, then replace the fan. If you have a C-frame or round motor, then you can still test for continuity. Set your multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. Now touch the probes to each terminal. Depending on the motor, there should be a resistance reading of around 20 to 4,000 ohms. Now if there's no resistance and no continuity, then the motor is faulty and should be replaced. Some motors can't be tested this way. If the resistance is more than 1 million ohms, then the motor likely has sealed internal components. This means you won't be able to test the resistance of the motor windings. If you're not sure if it's faulty, then it's still best to replace it. To install a new motor, you'll have to remove it from the mounting bracket. You can see this in more detail in the video linked below. If you have a side-by-side or bottom freezer model, then you might have an air damper motor that controls the airflow. First, unscrew the plastic housing and remove it. Now, disconnect the wires. Next, remove the damper motor. Now, test the motor for resistance. There should be a reading of around 1,000 to 10,000 ohms. If the reading is significantly off, or if there's no resistance and no continuity, then the motor is faulty and should be replaced. Some motors can't be tested this way. If the resistance is more than 1 million ohms, then the motor likely has sealed internal components. This means you won't be able to test the resistance of the motor windings. If you're not sure if it's faulty, then it's still best to replace it. Align the new motor assembly and snap it into place. Now reconnect the wires. Align the housing and tighten the screws. Now replace the cover. Some models use a sensor and a control board to regulate cooling. The temperature sensor is a heat-sensitive resistor, also known as a thermistor. As the temperature changes, so does the resistance. The control board monitors the resistance to determine the temperature. To test the sensor, it can be helpful to use a resistance chart, which is sometimes printed on the tech sheet. The tech sheet is normally behind the kick plate. It also might be mounted at the back or will be hidden under one of the top hinge covers. In many cases, the sensor can be accessed by removing a small cover. Disconnect the sensor wires and remove it. Now set the multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. Next, touch the probes to each terminal. At room temperature, we're getting a resistance of 2600 ohms, which is close to the rated value. For accuracy, it's best to take another measurement to compare. Test in a glass of ice water with a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. As the thermistor cools over several minutes, the resistance should now be close to the second value. If either test differs more than 10% from the rated value, or if there is no resistance and no continuity, then the sensor is faulty and should be replaced. Push the sensor into the bracket and reconnect the wires. Align the cover. Now tighten the mounting screw. If you have eliminated all other problems and the refrigerator is still not working properly, then it could be a problem with the control board. The board is often located near the back or in a small box behind the kick plate. First, do a visual inspection of the board. If you see any charred or blackened spots, then it's a good sign that there's a failed component or short circuit in the board. As well, double-check that all the wire connectors are secure. A loose connection might prevent components from receiving power. In many cases, it's best to install a new control board. You can see more in the video linked below. If needed, align the freezer panel and tighten the screws. Plug in the cord to reconnect the power. Now slide it back into place. Make sure to leave a couple of inches of space between the refrigerator and the wall. This will allow for proper airflow. Now test the refrigerator to see if it's working properly. If you like this and want to see more tutorials and informational videos, then subscribe to our channel. And if you need help, you can call or visit an AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.